She was truthful when lying was the common speech of men. She was honest when honesty became a lost virtue. She was a keeper of promises when the keeping of a promise was expected of no one. She was a rock of conviction in a time when men believed in nothing and scoffed at all things.
Speak louder because I.
Yeah.
Parfait. Okay. Là, c'est parfait en plus. Ouais. Yeah. I come from Orléans, which is Johanna von Orléans in German and Jeanne d'Arc. And my whole life, I passed the statue of Jeanne d'Arc and I visited the house. And every year, I was going to the festival de Jeanne d'Arc. And I was very obsessed with this person. Why was she so important? Why people followed her? And why did they burn her? And I was very confused.
I remember when I was young, there was a very big interest actually in witchcraft. And I was at that point already interested in, you know, like what happened in the Middle Ages with women at the time. It was something that moved me quite early, especially because it's connected to this person of Jeanne d'Arc, which is very present in Tavannes, I would say, background. I think she's also very close to the character and it's very, very close to her heart. So also the whole process was very much about Tavannes' feelings about it and, you know, like helping her in discovering this personality or this character.
There's my belonging in France. And Jeanne d'Arc is kind of this character that everybody knows. And on the other side, there's in my family, in my culture, the Laotian culture, spirits and witchcraft is something also really present. So it's like kind of these two cultures having this common nod, that is witchcraft. Jeanne d'Arc could not also be alive because she was a woman or a witch leading an army. They thought she was a witch because she was hearing voices, and I was like, they tried to change the real history of this person to fit into an academical storyline, which is often written by men and white men. And growing older, I was also comparing her to Marianne because Marianne is like, the image of France, but she's naked. And they used the woman, the image of a woman, so that men could feel equal and not feel compared to another masculine figure of power. We learned something so different in school, and we learned that Jeanne d'Arc is a martyr and she died because she wanted to sacrifice herself, but it's not true. So I wanted to explore this counter-narrative, exploring queerness and sensuality. What if she didn't burn? What if the flames are actually like making her power stronger? And what if people were scared of her and burnt her because she represented something that they could not access? So, yeah.
Thank you.
ourselves. Like the tides of earth, we are strong to come again. I believe in the goddess, the movement for life, formed by genderless, brightening for powerless and suffering our struggle. By the rose of my chakras, I tap the androgen. With you, our love is revolt. With you, we are each atoms of significance. Diana, my lover of Amazons, my triumph of bucket witches, feed us the lunar nectar between poems and tears, between silence and celebrations, and guide us to destroy the machinery that leads us. Kali, the source, the destroyer, the return, in pain's dignity, your face is behind our faces. We are strong to come again.
I really love the idea of witchcraft. In Spanish is brujería, and it's something that when Tavan mentioned that she wanted to do Jeanne d'Arc, in this sense, it really was like very interesting, because to be honest, there's a lot of powerful women in the past that were either burnt at the stake for being witches, or were witches, or displayed their power as women, and then they were kind of treated badly for it.
What did they mean by witchcraft? Like, paganism was witchcraft because it was not following the church, and because they were also more into being connected to nature, being connected to their own body, and the church wanted to take control of their bodies. The core of the idea came from this. I felt like, yes, Jeanne d'Arc is a witch, and she uncasted the spell of the church to reveal their own nature. And they free themselves. They become individuals instead of becoming like those soldiers that are following something they don't even understand, but it's easier to do so. And Jeanne d'Arc was strong enough and proud enough to believe it for herself, and trying to give this freedom to other people. I found this book that is called Witchcraft and the Gay Counterculture from Arthur Evans, and it talks about indigenous queers and witches, and it just gave an alternative history of Jeanne d'Arc, and there you can learn that actually she was imprisoned because she was a transvestite, because she didn't want to take off her armor, and she really didn't want to take it off because it was her faith, but also because if she did so, she would be raped by soldiers. So she had to do this to protect herself, but because of that, they imprisoned her and they condemned her.
Sie mich auf die Straße.
So the church was like repressing your own relationship to nature and your own relationship to your own body and your sexuality. For me, it was sure that it was about queerness and about questioning your identity, especially from a figure so important in history that everybody talks about. Like, she had to wear an armor because she goes to war, and when you go to war, you wear an armor. But actually, she wanted to wear this armor, and she could feel herself or themselves by wearing this armor. Queerness existed much before today, and we just don't talk about it.
I think with the performance, I got even more comfortable to wear let's say feminine clothes, because it was something that I was also dealing with, and I was not accepting, just not comfortable sometimes wearing women's clothes. And I think with this performance, really, like with the energy and doing it over and over again, like you just really get comfortable with your body and with the femininity and masculinity that we have inside each one of us.
Every time I think about the performance, not because it's like, whoa, we did something amazing, but because the story inspired me to do something. She's represented like, it's a little bit, she's a witch, or she's in an armor, or she's a general, you don't know. But you can tell it's something solemn. She's a figure of authority. It's a bit like a chevalier and a mage. She's also wearing like with this veil, the idea of like death, to be ready for your death because it doesn't mean anything. And then there's like those soldiers that are dressed with black trash bags. And this was an idea brought by one of the dancers. We wanted them to have a very strong look, but also a bit weird. And it really helped that the shape is really hiding Jeanne when she transforms.
Dark changes, it's really like a bit extreme, no? Really, really extra, extra. People sexualize certain parts, but no, I decide to show it and to cover all the parts that.
There were a lot of like boundaries that were kind of brought down, and we just became a lot more intimate, like. And more comfortable just touching each other.
And also to find like a certain connection to the topic sex in a way like this.
To some extent we had to go to the extreme where it's like you're pulling someone's hair or you're grabbing someone's
intimate parts.
Boob, yeah, intimate parts. And then from that you go down to like the normal like touching and feeling.
And I think this is actually like the most beautiful thing about it, that at one point we were so comfortable with each other, but to be comfortable with each other, we first have to be comfortable with ourselves.
It was also cool to bring in the drag portion of that, because it's also like queer community that has also been treated badly. Yeah, it was kind of cool to bring all of that together and and show the world that we're still here.
And this idea of Jeanne d'Arc grew really in my mind for a long time. But I never found the courage or the platform to bring it.
I think like all of us were a little bit challenged with this idea that we also have to develop our own characters.
We all identify to Jeanne d'Arc in our own special way, you know. Sometimes we disagree, but why do we disagree? Because we have different stories of what Jeanne d'Arc did.
Like it took us a while to go from just pose, to really embrace the poses and to really go out of ourselves. It was a process to get there.
I feel so grateful for this character because it really gave me the strength to do it. And at the beginning I was like, I'm not ready, but actually I have to do it.
It is very liberating. I think like in both states, you feel different things.
Yeah, for
sure. So like with the darkness, you also feel like kind of like letting go of some of your darkness also. And then experience like, yeah, the light. Yeah.
Jeanne d'Arc gave me strength and agency. It just inspired me a lot. I want to do this performance again for sure, in a different context.
I think it was also the first time that anyone saw it, so it was like actually the time that we performed for an audience, and we could really see like the vibration and the energy that the audience was bringing to us, and like people shouting and stuff like this, and you really really feel this energy, and it is like actually like a trance.
You sensed the excitement, you know, you didn't know what was happening, and I think we all in the group managed to then be in this moment and in this zone.
Yeah, you just give your all and like you're, I think it's exactly like the performance, like you transcend, yeah. You know, you liberate yourself.
I don't know, maybe there's different chapters in Jeanne d'Arc. She's calling for different goddesses, but maybe she's calling also to other sisters whose history has been changed. We have to honor her sacrifice, like what they did to her. We have to replace the truth right now, you know?
People are still having sex. Lust keeps on lurking. Nothing makes them stop. This AIDS thing's not working. People are still having sex. It's been going on for quite a while. Perhaps it's quite fashionable. It hasn't gone out of style. Having sex right now.